वक्रतुण्डमघाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं वागर्थादिव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरो वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरो येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। अयि उन् ऋलक् एओं
एओं
ऐ औच्
ऐ
औच्
हयवरट्
हयवरट्
लन्
लन्
न्यामाङ्गाणम्
न्यामाङ्गाणम्
झभै
झभै
घढधश्
घढधश्
झभगढधश्
झभगढधश्
खपचठत चटतौ
खपचठत चटतौ
कपै
शशसर्
हल्
हल्
अकुहविसर्जनीयानां कण्ठः इचुयशानां तालु ऋतुरशानां मूर्धा लुतुलसानां दन्ताः उपोपद्मानीयानां ओष्ठौ ज्ञामाङ्गाणानां नासिका च एदैतोः कण्ठतालु ओदौतोः कण्ठौष्ठम्
ఉదౌతోష్టం
వకారస్య దంతౌష్టం జిహ్వామూలీయస్య జిహ్వామూల్యం
జిహ్వామూలీయస్య జిహ్వామూల్యం
నాసికా అనుస్వారస్య
అస్మద్శబ్దృషులింగేషు సమానరూపః
మహ్యం మే ఆవాభ్యాం నౌ అస్మభ్యం నః మత్ ఆవాభ్యాం అస్మత్ మమ మే ఆవయోగో నౌ అస్మాకం నః మయి ఆవయోగో అస్మాసు నకారాంతః యుష్మశ్శబ్దః త్రిషు లింగేషు సమానరూపః
త్వం
యువాం యూయం త్వాం త్వా యువాం వాం యుష్మాన్ వః తుభ్యం తే యువాభ్యాం వాం యుష్మభ్యం వః యుష్మాసు We'll continue with the translation. But before that, this Atmanipadi dhatus, some dhatus we have seen, the forms. லப் தாது லபதே லபேதே லபந்தே லபசே லபேதே லபத்தே லபே லபாவகே லபாமகே. லப் இஸ் அன் ஆத்மனி பரி தாது. டேக்கிங் லப் அஸ் எ மாஸ்டர் சப்தா கேன் டிக்ளைன் தி ஆத்மனிபதி தாதுஸ். So if you know lab dhatu, other atmanepadi dhatus can be declined. In general, there will be exceptions. Exceptions will be there. But to some extent, we can know the form of the dhatu when it declined. Okay, these are some dhatus, whatever we have seen, some listed here. So the whether the dhatu is a parasmipadi or atmanepadi, we will know only when we use, when we become familiar with the language. There is no, you know, it's not possible to know at this point whether the dhatu is atmanepadi or parasmipadi. It's difficult. Only by familiarity we will come to know. Okay, so this is ஆத்மனி பரிதாது. திஸ் இஸ் ஆத்மனி பரிதாது. ஜஸ்ட் ஒன் மினிட். சோ தேர் ஆர் சம் தாதுஸ் விச் ஆர் உபயபதி. தேர் ஆர் சம் தாதுஸ் விச் ஆர் உபயபதி. வாட் இஸ் உபயபதி? இட் கேன் டேக் Parsmipadi as well as it can take the Parsmipadi as well as Atmanipadi form. That is the Pratyaya, whatever we saw, that Ti, Taha, Anti for Parsmipadi, Ante, Ite, Ante for Atmanipadi. The suffixes belonging to Parsmipadi as well as Atmanipadi, Idhatu can take. That is called Ubhayapadi. So, I'll give some Ubhayapadi. I'm going to type here. Some dhatus Ubhayapadi. You can mute your mic. Okay, thank you. Do you see the words by what I'm typing?
Yes, Sharanji.
Okay. Just a minute, there's some problem in typing. பரஸ்மை pada form as well as atmane pada form. Only eighth vachanam I am typing. I am going to type now. The meaning I will say, I won't be able to type now. Meaning I will say, maybe I will type later. Pach Dhatu, for example. Pach Dhatu is a Ubhayapadi Dhatu. Pach Dhatu is a Ubhayapadi Dhatu. Therefore, the form can be Pachati, Pachataha, Pachanti. Pach means to cook. So I'm giving only a Pratama Purusha Ekavachana form. Okay, Pratama Purusha Ekavachana form. Pachati, Pachataha, Pachanti. Pachasi, Pachataha, Pachata. Pachami, Pachavaha, Pachamaha. This is Parasmai for the forms, for the Pach Dhatu. And Atmanepadi, it will be Pachate. Pachate, Pachete, Pachante. Pachase, Pachete, Pachadve. Pache, Pachavahe, Pachamahe. And similarly, Andhra Dhatu, Ni Dhatu. What is the meaning of Ni? Ni to lead. Ni Dhatu, Ni means to lead or to bring, to carry. Nayati, Nayataha, Nayanti. Nayasi, Nayataha, Nayata. Nayami, Nayavaha, Nayamaha. That is the Parasmit Padi form. And in Atmanipadi, it will be Nayate. It becomes Nayate, Nayate, Nayete, Nayante. Nayase, Nayete, Nayadve. Naye, Nayamake, Nayamake. And next Dhatu, Buddha Dhatu. Buddha Dhatu, Buddha means to know. Buddha, to know. So, Bodhati, Bodhataha, Bodhanti. Bodhasi, Bodhataha, Bodhata. Bodhami, Bodhavaha, Bodhamaha, Buddha Dhatu. And its Atmanepadi form will be Bodhate. Bodhate, Bodhete, Bodhante. Bodhase, Bodhete, Bodhadve. Bodhe, Bodhavage, Bodhamage. Buddha Dhatu. Then, the next Dhatu, I'm giving some Dhatus. Bhaj Dhatu, Bhaj. Sevaya, Buddha to know, Bhaj, Sevaya. The form will be Bhajati Bhajataha Bhajanti. Bhajati Bhajataha Bhajanti, Bhajasi Bhajataha Bhajata, Bhajami Bhajavaha Bhajamaha. This is Atmanepadi form, Bhajati. Sorry, Parasmepadi form. An Atmanepadi form it will be Bhajate. Bhajate, Bhajete, Bhajante. Bhajase, Bhajete, Bhajadve. Bhaje, Bhajamake, Bhajamake. So, and similarly, another Dhatu. Dhav Dhatu. Okay, I type here. a problem in typing because I'm sharing. That's why I'm not able to type. In this Mahaprana, if I have difficult to type here. Dhav Dhatu. Dhav means to run. One meaning is to run. Dhav Dhatu. There's another meaning also, Dhav. And that when you decline Dhav Dhatu, it is Dhavati, Dhavataha, Dhavanti. Dhavasi, Dhavataha, Dhavata. Davami, Davavaha, Davamaha. And Atmanepadi will be Davate. Atmanepadi will be Davate. Davate, Davete, Davante. Davase, Davete, Davadve. Dave, Davamahe, Davamahe. And one more Dhatu I'll give. Yach Dhatu. Yach. Yach means yachana, to beg. That is yachati, yachataha, yachanti, yachasi, yachataha, yachata, yachami, yachavaha, yachamaha. And Atmanepadi form will be yachate. Yachate, yachete, yachante, yachase, yachete, yachadve, yache, yachavake, yachamake.
Dhavati means run, no?
Yeah, yeah, Davati to run. Dav to run. It also means wash, also meaning is Gati Shuddhyoho. That is Shuddha. In the sense of cleaning, cleansing, that meaning also is there for Dav. Anyway, these are some of Dhatus. There are many more Dhatus are there. So, the next class I will type and show you. So now, in our exercise, when we have these dhatus, we can try to use the Atmanepadi form. Can try to use the Atmanepadi form. So this six dhatus are there. Some other few dhatus are there. We'll see. We'll see in the next class. So these are the important dhatus. Pach is a famous dhatu. Pachana kriya. Ni, to bring, to carry. Buddha, to know. Bhaj. Bhaj is sevayam, to resort to. Bhaj. Dhav, to run or to wash. Yach, to ask for. To beg, to ask for. Yachati, yachate. Iti. So you can try to use the Atmanepadi forms. Sabha dhatus, the list I will give. The next class I will give. Okay. So that, since already we have seen the Paraspanepadi and Atmanepadi, Upayapadi we have not seen. So therefore, I thought of giving the list, but I have a problem in typing. So we will I'll type some more dhatus. We'll see in the next class. So how do we know whether it's a Paraspanepadi or Atmanepadi? As I said, Panini Maharishi has given that in these dhatupata, dhatus are classified into Paraspanepadi and Atmanepadi. So that is the only source we can know. And they say that if the result of the action goes to the person himself who does the action, then Atmanepadi form should be used. If the result of action goes to the other person, if it is done for the sake of others, then Paraspanepadi to be used. It is said like that.
And can you repeat?
If the result of the action, if the result of action goes to the person himself who does the action, then Paraspanepadam should be used.
Okay.
Sorry, Atmanepadam should be used. If the result of action goes to the person himself, then Atmanepadam should be used. If the result of action, if the Kriyapala goes to others, if it is done for the sake of others, then Paraspanepadam should be used. There is no base to this. This is in general. It is in general. This is followed in the in the Vedic Sanskrit, but in classical Sanskrit it is not like that. It is used interchangeably. In spoken Sanskrit, in classical Sanskrit letter, it is not used in that sense. Even we can use Atmanepada for others also. And
Sharanji?
Yeah.
Is it okay if you give one example, result goes to the same
okay.
person who's... Yeah, so that way we could relate it much better.
Ramaha Pachate. I have some difficulty in typing. That's okay. Anyway, I'll try to type here. You can see. Ramaha Pachate. Okay. Just go. Here I'm typing. Ramaha Pachate. Rama does. Rama cooks. Okay. Ramaha Pachate. Who cooks? Rama. Pachate is there. So Rama cooks for himself.
Ramaha
Yachate also can, no? Yes. Ramaha Pachate. Rama cooks for himself. Whereas Sudaha Pachati. Sudaha Pachati. Sudaha is the cook, the chef. He cooks for whom? He cooks for others. Pachati. So, Ramaha Pachate, Sudaha Pachati. Rama, he cooks for himself. Whereas, the chef, the cook, he cooks for, not only for himself, but for others also. In fact, he cooks for others. Sudaha, right?
Okay. Makes sense. I actually wrote, result goes to the object, but that's not true. Result goes to others. Okay.
Result goes to the karta only, not to the karma.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Right. So makes sense. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, therefore, Sudaha. Okay, this is an example, but as I said before, it is not strictly followed. It's not like that. Okay. In the classical Sanskrit, it is used. In the classical Sanskrit, it can be used anyway. Ramaha Pachati also you can say. Nothing wrong in that. Sudaha Pachati, Ramaha Pachati. You can say. Nothing wrong in that. Okay. So that it is used interchangeably. But according to Panini Maharishi, the dhatus are classified. See, some dhatus, it doesn't have Parasmaipadi form, as we saw, the list of dhatus which are Parasmaipadi and the list of dhatus which are Atmanepadi. They don't have the other form, right? So for example, going is there. Ramaka Gachati only. There is no Gachate. Whether Rama goes for himself or others, or Rama eats, okay, Rama eats. Does he eat for others or for himself? He eats for himself. So there is no Kadate. It is not that. Kadati is a the Parasmaipadi Dhatu. So Parasmaipadam Kad is a only Parasmaipada suffixes can be applied to the Kad Dhatu. So Ramaha Kadati only. Some Dhatus are classified as Paraspai Padam. Some Dhatus are classified as Atmane Padam. So there we cannot apply this logic there. But only for the Dhatus which are Ubaya Padam. Ubaya Padam. We can apply this. As I told, this is not strictly followed. Maybe in the Vedas it is followed, but in the classical Sanskrit it is not followed. So we can use as we like. We can use Ubhayapadi, we can use Atmanepadi or Parasmaipadi. We can use according to our choice. But when you use Ramaha Pachate, it is understood Rama cooks for himself. That is in general. But that's why we say Ramaha Pachati. Ramaha Pachati, he cooks for himself and he cooks for others. There's no, both, it has got that meaning. So no problem with that. When you specifically use Pachate, it means Rama, he cooks for himself because you're using the Atmanepadi form. Okay. This is there are some few dhatus are there which are ubhayapadi. Which are ubhayapadi. Okay. We will continue. We'll do we'll see some more dhatus in the next class. Okay. So now we'll continue with the exercise. I think we are doing this story part. There is a forest. Ekam manam masti. A lion is living there. Tatra ekaha singaha vasati. Saha bhagudushtaha asti. Saha pratidinam pashun kadati. Ekada shrihalaha tatra agachati. Saha singham pashyati. Saha trasyate. Saha bibhyati. See, it is bibhyati is bhagavachanam. Bibhyati is bhagavachanam. It is bibeti. Bibeti. Bibitaha bibhyati. You can note. Last class I use bibhyati. Bibhyati is bhagavachanam. Te bibhyati. Saha bibeti. Okay.
Vyatate we have taken down, afraid of, but you said we can't use it here.
Vyatate,
it is in our Dhatupata list.
Yeah, what is it? What is the meaning given? To be afraid of. Vyatate also you can use. Yes, Vyatate you can use. It means by a such chalana yoga, you can use Vyatate also. Saka Vyatate.
Okay.
Yeah. It is Atmanipati. Okay. Yatate also can be used. So Bibeti, I think Shyamji told it is Bibeti, Avibeti Kadachanati. Bibeti is Ekavachanam. Bibhyati is Bhagavachanam. It is Bibhyati I used, it is wrong. It is Bibeti. Bibeti, Bibitaha, Bibitaha, two forms are there for Dvivachanam. So those Bibitaha, Bibitaha. For Dvivachanam, Bibitaha, Bibitaha, two forms are there. Anyway, don't worry about it. Bibeti, Ekavachanam, and Bibhyati, Bhagavachanam. So, Saha, Bibeti, or Vyatate also you can use, afraid of. Okay. Then the next line. The line goes near the fox. Okay, I will call the name from the chat box.
Sundar. Yeah. I've got one doubt.
Yeah.
This shrigalaha, it is shakara plus rikara. Is it like that? Tr.
No. Shakara plus r only. Shrigalaha.
Because while writing is shr plus r. Shrikara plus r is what?
It is not a shr. See, shakara plus repa plus r you are saying. No. Shakara plus r only. For example, Shakara plus ra is shrama, but shrama and all.
Okay. Yeah, but there, how do you write shra? Shra is?
Shaka,
Shra and r, I mean, the way it is written is shra plus r.
Is there any word?
No, but the way it is written.
No, the way it is not written. Okay, I think, see, if it is, okay, I will type here, you can see. Shakara plus
Repa.
Shakara plus R is Shakara is written like this. The Shakara you can see.
Ah, that is Shru, yes.
Shru, okay.
Yes, but there you have written it differently. See.
Where? The same thing, Shru.
No, when you see the ghost near the fox, right next to Simaha, right next to that.
Not there. There it's different.
Where you're saying?
Down. The lion goes near the fox. Simhaha.
Oh, yeah. That is wrong. Okay.
Right. The right way is the one you're written at the top.
That's typo. Okay.
Right. That's the right way.
Yes. It is Shiru only.
Right. Thank
you. Okay. It's a typo. Then the lion goes near the fox. Singaha shrigalasya samipam gacchati. Then the lion wants to eat the fox. So that part we saw in the last class. Singaha shrigalam khaditum ichchati. That khaditum, we saw in the last class. Kartum, to do. Khaditum, to eat. That infinite, right?
Yadi tarhi won't come.
Where?
Lion wants to eat the fox, then fox wants to eat the fox.
What is the meaning of Edi and Targi?
If then.
Edi, Targi, what is the meaning?
If Edi, then.
If then. But where is that if then here, the sentence?
That's why I asked.
It is not, therefore you cannot use. Lion wants to eat the fox. So you cannot use Edi, Targi here. Mm-hmm. See, Edi, Targi, when can you use that? There are two actions are involved. If he goes there, he can meet his friend, suppose. If he goes there, it's one part of the sentence. He can meet his friend is another part. So, therefore, two actions are there. If one action is completed, other action can be completed. But here, it is not there. The lion wants to eat the fox. By saying the want and eat, I think there are two actions. It's not like that. That is why we are using now tum. Lion wants to eat the fox. Kaditum ichchati. Singaha ichchati. Kim ichchati. Kaditum ichchati. It wants to eat. What it wants to eat? Shrigalam. Therefore, Shrigalam is the object of kaditum. Or it can be the object of ichchati also. It is the same, it is the object for both. Kaditum means to do. Kaditum means to eat. To eat what? Shrigala. And Shrigala is what is desired by lion also. So, Singaha Shrigala Ichchati, it likes Shrigala. Singaha Shrigala Kaditum Ichchati, it wants to eat Shrigala. Okay. So, for Shrigala is 2-1, karma. It is the karma. Karma for the both the dhatu, both the kriya, both the dhatu. Ka dhatu is a kaditum and ichchati is a ish dhatu, ichchati. For both, Shrigala is the karma, the object. Therefore, it is in Dvitiya Vibhakti. Kaditum, it means to eat. Patitum, to read. Kartum, to do. Gantum, to go. Right? Agantum, to come. So, the tum will be there. Whenever the tum is there, understand that is infinite. That is in the sense of to do something. To do something. That is the meaning. So, when you see a padam with tum ending, understand it is an avyaya. It is an avyaya. Avyaya cannot be declined. Okay, avyaya cannot be declined. So, kaditum is kaditum only. So, from a dhatu, by adding a particular suffix, we are getting an avyaya. Dhatu is kadu dhatu. We add some suffix. Here, tum is a suffix. It's very clear. Tum is there as part of the word. So, tum is a suffix we add. When you add tum suffix to the dhatu, what you get is an avyaya, kaditum. But when you add tum, it is not straightforward. If you add tum to kru dhatu, it becomes kartum. Pat dhatu becomes patitum. Kad dhatu becomes kaditum. To gam dhatu, it doesn't become gamitum. It becomes gantum. There, some changes happen. Changes happen depending on the dhatu, depending on which group, which gana the dhatu belongs and all. Okay. So not gana, depends on what dhatu is. Whether it is, we'll see what it is. It's too early to know about those things. So we have to know this form. Kaditum, when we use in our exercise, you understand the form, tum forms. Kaditum, patitum. It is kru dhatu, not karitum. It is kartum. So don't say karitum. There is no word karitum. Kartum. patitum, gantum, nidatu, netum. We will see. We will see. This is a separate topic. We will see later. In the translation, I am using kaditum. Simple. Singha shigalam kaditum icchati. Or singha shigalam icchati also fine. The lion desires. It likes the fox. That's all. That also, if you find the kaditum is difficult to understand now, you can remove kaditum. Then just make it simple. Singha shigalam icchati. It desires shigala. Fine. Okay.
Now, is there a reason why we're using thum? Because there are two verbs here. Is that the reason, Sharanji? Why?
Yeah, a lion wants to eat. What does it see? It likes shigala for what? For eating? That means the sentence is to eat. Therefore, kaditum. Okay.
Okay.
You go to school for what? To read. Agam gachami. Kutra gachami. LG, you answer. I go to school. Agam gachami. Kutra gachami.
To study.
No. I go. See. I go. Gachami. Agam gachami. My question is kutra gachami. Where do I go?
School.
What is the word for school? Is it a karta or a karma or karana? What is that?
That's the object.
So what is the vibhakti it will take? What vibhakti will take?
I have to refer Sharanji, I'm sorry.
No. See, Vidyalaya is there. Rama.
Vidyalaya. Okay. Vidyalaya.
Vidyalaya, simple.
Vidyalaya.
Vidyalaya is the object for Rama because it's a place, it's a destination. The place of destination, the place of destination is also considered to be object, karma in Sanskritam. So Ramaha Vidyalayam Gachati. Kimartam Gachati. Kimartam Ramaha Vidyalayam Gachati. Patitum Gachati.
Patit. Okay.
He goes there to read. Okay.
Okay.
Saha Gachati. Okay. He goes to the dining hall. He goes to the dining hall. How do you say in Sanskritam? He goes. First you say goes. Who goes? He goes.
Saha.
Saha?
Saha gachati.
Kutra gachati.
Dining hall. That.
Simple. If you use the word alaya, you can join. What is the word for eating? What is the word for eating?
Kada.
Bhojana, right? Bhojana is a...
Bhojana, okay.
Bhojana and alayas.
Bhojanalayam.
Bhojanalayam. Simple, right? Bhojanalayam. Khadanalayam also you can say, anywhere. That Bhojanalayam. Where you go eat. Saha Bhojanalayam gachati. Kimartam gachati. Why does he go to Bhojanalayam?
To eat food.
Eat is there already in the sentence. We just now saw. Khaditam is there.
Khaditum, okay.
Khaditum saha bhojanalayam gacchati.
Khaditum, okay.
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 Simple. So he goes there for what? To eat, to do something. So therefore tum will come. And tum is the word ending with tum is an abhyaya. Indeclinable. So don't think tum is there. So makarantaha. Pullinga and apumsakanlinga, no. It is an abhyaya. How do you get the kaditum? Dhatu is kadu dhatu. You add the suffix. See, in Sanskritam, the important thing is pratyaya, suffix. There are so many suffixes are there. The suffixes and the classifications are there. Like for the shabda, there are set of suffix. For the dhatus, there are set of suffix. And from a dhatu, you can derive, from a dhatu, you are deriving a kriyapadam. Like kad is a dhatu, from that you get kadati, kadataha, kadanti, kriyapadam. And similarly, from a shabda, you derive a namapadam. Similarly, from a dhatu, you can derive a namapadam also. From a dhatu, you can derive a namapadam by adding a particular suffix. From the dhatu, you can derive an abhyaya padam also. Example, by adding tum. So, lot of suffixes are there which are added to dhatu or to the shabda. Even a shabda can take a suffix and it can become a kriya padam. Possible. Shabda can take a suffix and become a kriya padam. That's all possible. It is there. So lot of suffixes are there. Right? So the suffixes are important. Suffixes are important. So many suffixes are there. That we will see when we study grammar.
That will be studying separately or side-by-side?
Sorry?
The suffixes will be studying separately as like a chapter
as part of the the class we will study. I will introduce a suffix now, but we are not yet prepared. So that's why I'm not getting
is the suffix but exact meaning in
your voice is not clear. Some noises are. Are you using
speaker? Suffix has got exact meaning. No, I am. Can you hear me?
Are you using headphone or speaker?
There is background noise. Sound is coming.
Not about the background. Okay, your voice is not clear. Tell me again. Hello.
You know what the suffix has equivalent meaning in English?
I don't understand what you speak. What does it say?
The suffix, you know. Now, what is exam meaning in English?
Suffix is the word in English. And Sanskrit the word is pratyaya.
Yeah.
Yeah. I use the word suffix.
It's a suffix. So what is the exact?
What is the exact meaning of suffix? What does it mean in English?
I know suffix means adi. When you add in the last.
Uh-huh.
That is
because suffix when I think I understood his question. Meaning. By adding tum, what is this gaditum becomes? That's his question.
No, I already told the
that particular terms. Meaning of you told me there are a lot of suffixes we'll add. So there is particular meaning to all this.
Which anyway, I don't understand. Your voice is not clear. So you can message me, I will answer probably. Yeah, otherwise, if anyone understands this question, you can let me know. Anyway, so the word for suffix is pratyaya in Sanskrit. There are many pratyayas are there. So many pratyayas are there. So whether it is a namapadam or a kriyapadam, it can be derived from a dhatu or a shabda by adding suffixes. Right? And avyaya padam also can be derived from the dhatu. For that example is khaditum. Khad being a dhatu, adding a particular suffix to pratyaya, you get khaditum.
Charanji,
yeah.
One question. Everything has come from dhatu.
Yes, you can say yes. Not you cannot just not totally like that. But dhatus are the
main voice.
The backbone of the language. Yes, there are some words which doesn't have dhatu. There are some words which don't have dhatu, which cannot be derived from a dhatu. See, there are two matas are the two opinions. Again, your side also having problem. My problem is that there are two opinions are there. One is vyutpattivada, other one is rudivada. Vyutpattivada, they say any word can be traced to its dhatu. That is called Vyutpattivada. Rudi is there. Rudi is the words have meaning. Its etymology cannot be known. That is another mata, another opinion. So, we also say to some extent we can know, we can get into the etymology. To some extent, there are some words which have certain meaning whose etymology cannot be derived. There are some words like that. Okay. So these are two matas, two different opinions. Anyway, let it be there. Fine. We will get into the class. Now the next sentence. Sundarji. Then the fox cries. Singaha shrigalam kaditum icchati. Then
the fox cries. Tadanim shrigalaha krandati.
Tadani
Srigalaha Krandati.
Idanim Shrigalaha. Krandati is good. Another word?
Rodati. Roditi.
Roditi. Good. It is Roditi. Oh God, what is the problem? Roditi. You can say Roditi also. Krandati or Roditi? Both are fine. Good. Okay. Then the lion asks the fox, why do you cry? The next person, Rama Venkatramanji.
Yeah. The lion asks the fox, why do you cry? Sinhaha Shrigalam Prichati.
Krandati. Oh, okay. There's some problem, sir. Okay. Yeah. Singaha Shrigalam Prichati. Singaha Prichati. Kam Prichati.
Shrigalam.
Shrigalam Prichati. So Shrigalam, Shrigala is what? What is Shrigala? Shrigala is the karma. Singaha Shrigalam Prichati. Kim Prichati?
Why do you cry? Kimartam?
Kimartam?
Vam Krandasi.
Kimartam?
Vam Krandasi or Rodisi?
Krandasi. Or Rodishi.
Rodishi.
Rodishi. It is Murdanya. Vam Kimartam Iti. You have to say Iti. From Sanskritam, we don't have the quote. Punctuation marks are not there. So, Singaha Shrigalam Prachati Kimartam Tvam Rodishi Iti. Right? So, Kimartam Tvam Rodishi, that which is in quote. That is known by Iti. By saying Iti. Okay. So, then the next person, Kameshwarji. Fox tells, oh sir, there is another line here.
Shrigalaha Vadati. Sir, can we use G? Atra.
Boho.
Sorry, Boho. You can use Boho. What's addressing, right? Boho or
Mahodaya.
Mahodaya. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Boho. There is another line here.
Atra.
Yeah.
Atra Anya Simhaha Asti.
Atra Anya. Anya. Okay.
Another.
Anya. Another. So Anyaha Simhaha.
Okay. Anyaha Simhaha Asti.
Anyaha Simhaha Asti.
Can we say Anyatha Simhaha Asti?
Why Anyatha? What does it mean Anyatha? Anyatha is Mahaprana. Anyatha is otherwise.
No, Anyata, Fastita.
No, that also, what does it mean, Anyata?
I thought it means another, no?
No, Anyaha is another. Anyata is the status of being another. So that is also Shrilinga. It won't, it not only. Anyaha Singha Asti. Then, Sumateji, he eats my son, therefore I cry.
Saha, Mama Putram. Kadati.
Chaka mama.
Putram.
Kadati.
Kadati.
Okay.
Tataha aham krandami.
Tataha aham.
Aham krandami or.
Rodimi.
Okay.
Tataha aham krandami atwa rodimi.
Rodimi.
Then the lion asks, where is the other lion?
Tada
Simhaha Prichati Anya Simhaha putra asti iti
tada
tada simhah prichati
prichati kim prichati
anya simhah putra asti iti
anyas anyaha simhah putra asti putra asti
anyaha simhah putra asti iti.
The fox tells, next person, the fox tells there is a well nearby. Next person is Chandranji.
Shrikalaha Simha, Simha toyam paschati. The fox tells.
Shrikalaha tells there is a well nearby.
Acha, I will tell. Shrikalaha kutra samudham. Yeah, some, oh, I have missing that. So I will tell now. Shrigalaha Vadati.
Okay.
Oh, my writing has gone. I don't know. Shrigalaha Vadati. Atra ye kubaha asti. Atra samimam ye kubaha asti. Atra samimam ye egam kubaha asti.
Samipe. Samipe, there is a well nearby. Samipe Upaha
Asti.
Asti.
What? Kupa means it is singular. Okay, Kupaha Asti. Idi. Idi.
Yes, that's all. Shrigalaha Vadati, Samipe Upaha Asti. Next person, Shyamji.
1 minute, Shamyatam. Why do we use this Iti? I don't understand. Iti everywhere.
There is a well nearby. Who says this?
Fox tells. Oh, that. Okay, like that. Indirect, we are making it indirect.
Not indirectly. In Sanskrit, we don't have the punctuation. So,
okay.
Whatever is said by the person, that's a quote. Iti means quote. Quote by the person.
Okay, understood.
Anipe Kupaha Asti is the quote of the Shrigala.
Okay. Then samipe, why do we use samipe, not samipam?
Samipe, there is a well nearby, therefore samipe. You are saying it is located at a place, therefore samipe.
No, samipam is also nearby, no? Samipam.
Samipe, you have to use here, not samipam. If you are going near, then samipam. But he is pointing to a well which is has got a location, so samipe.
Okay. Thank you, Ji.
The next person, Shyamji.
He lives there.
This also comes under code. Okay. Actually, everything comes under code. So we can. This will goes along with the previous sentence.
Yeah. He lives there. Saha tatra asti iti.
Okay. Shrigalaha Vadati Samipe Kupaha Asti.
Saha Tatra Vasati.
Saha Tatra. Samipe Ekaha Kupaha Asti. Samipe Ekaha Kupaha Asti. Saha Tatra Vasati. The lion tells, we go there, I see the lion, I kill it. Can do something.
Simhaha vadati avam gachavaha aham simham pashyami aham tam vadhami iti.
Avam, we go there.
Avam gachavaha.
Gachavaha.
Aham simham pashyami.
Pashyami.
Aham tam vadhami iti.
Tam vadhami. Vadha tamaha pranam. Okay, vadhami.
Vadhami iti.
Then the next person. The fox tells, oh sir, please come, I show you. Yeah, so the surrender ji.
Yeah. Fox tell, oh sir, please come. I show you. Singalaha vadadi bhavan. Bhavan agach. Bhavan agachadi aham. Tom.
Please come. What do you say? Bhavan.
Please, what do you say? Bhavan agachati.
Agachati, not agachati. Okay. You can say agachati is the, it's a present tense, latlakara. Please come. Agachatu. We will see later this lakara. Agachatu. It's a, when you are invading someone or requesting someone or when you command someone, so you have to use agachatu. Agachatu. It is another lakara. Another tense. It, not tense, it is in fact the mood. In Sanskritam, you remember I told there are tenses and moods.
Particles.
Sorry?
Agachatu, or past tense.
I don't understand what you say.
Agachatu means present and present participle.
No, it's not like that. Agachatu means when you are inviting someone, you have to say agachatu. Agachati is he comes. Agachatu is please come. Okay, Bhavan agachatu.
Bhavan just agacha, we cannot say, Sharanji.
With respect is agachatu.
Oh, with respect agachatu. Okay.
Padatu, yeah.
Sharanji, can we not add kripaya agachatu? Please.
Yeah, you can say kripaya, Bhavan kripaya agachatu. It's good. Kripaya is abhyaya. Kripaya agachatu. Bhavan kripaya agachatu. So you can note down this. See, agachatu, the two part we have not seen. Like we have seen so far only let lakara. Present tense only we have seen. We have not seen any other tense and moods. You can, when you do translation, these things will come. So slowly we will learn one by one. So you can now note this, agachatu. Already in the exercise part we have seen, when we reading the exercise, there you will see purayatu, kripaya, what is that? Fill in the blank. Uttasthanani purayantu. We have seen, right? So it means what? It's a request. It's a request or a command. So it's a particular lakara, which it's called moods. Tenses are there. Tenses is past tense, present tense, future tense. And in Sanskritam, there are 6 tenses are there and 4 moods. So one among the mood is agachatu. When you are requesting someone, you have to add the suffix tu. And with respect is agachatu. Without respect, agacha. Okay. And suppose you're asking, see, when you're asking, may I come, right? Agam, agachani, agachani. Okay. So like the patat, gachati, gachataka, gachanti, gachasi, gachataka, gachata, gachami, gachavaha, gachamaha. That is for let. Similarly, for this particular mood, it is called lot in Sanskritam. Agachatu, agachatam, agachantu. It can be declined. Agacha, agachatam, agachata, agachani, agachava, agachama. So aham agachani, may I come? It's a request. So here the fox is asking, please come. So it is requesting the lion to come. Therefore, bhavan agachatu, kripaya agachatu, not agachati. Agachati denotes the action, present action. But here it is a request on the part of the fox. Therefore, agachatu. Okay, now you learned only the Pratama Purusha, that is enough. Madhyama Purusha, Uttama Purusha, you can leave it out, not required. So, agachatu. So, whenever tu is there, it could be a command or could be a request or invitation. Right? Bhavan patatu, suppose they say, you please read. Bhavan gachatu, you please go. Bhavan upavishatu, you please sit. Right? So Bhavan is there, therefore tu. If it is tvam is there, then tu will not come. Tvam agacha, tvam pata. Okay, fine. This much is enough for this mood. Then I show you. How do you say that? Bhogo, kripaya agachatu, I show you.
Aham, tvam pashyami.
I see you. I show you, not see you. Not pashyami. What is the difference between showing and seeing?
Seeing, showing means, you are showing, seeing
means. You are saying, aham pashyami, I see. What? It is not pashyami. I see, okay. That is one part. You said pashyami, okay. Leave that. Aham tvam pashyami. What is tvam pashyami? What is tvam there?
Tvam pashyami.
Agam tvam. It is, yeah, good. That part, which is very nice. You understood that. Agam tvam. It's an object. Agam tvam. Darshayami. Okay, not parshayami.
Darshayami.
Of course, darshayami, it's, we have to use future tense, but it doesn't matter. We can use present tense. I show you. Agam darshayami. Pashyami, seeing. Darshayami, causing to see. Show. I show you. Agam tvam. Darshayami. I show you. Right? Understand? Hello? Surendraji.
Hello?
Darshayami. Darshayati, darshayataha, darshayant.
Darshayasi,
darshayataha, darshayata. Darshayami. Agam darshayami. I show you. Agam tvam darshayami. I show you. Now, Sundarji. Now, the fox comes near the well.
Shrigalaha kupam samipe agachati.
Kupam samipe. Okay. Shrigalaha agachati. Right?
Agachati.
Kutra agachati.
Near the well. That is, well is kupam. That is near kupe samipam agachati.
Kupe, what is kupe?
Okay. That is also kupam samipam.
No. Why did you say kupe?
Yeah. I am unable to explain, but
you said kupe and
yeah,
samipam.
Near kupasya samipam.
Good.
Kupasya samipam.
Not kupe. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Kupe is the place, the location. You will see that. We have not seen the karaka.
Okay.
We have seen only katrakaraka, karmakaraka, not even karanakaraka. That is why I am very careful in the exercise. I have not used any other karaka. Only you will see subject and object. First you understand subject and object and other karakas.
Okay.
So,
kupasya.
And Shashti Vibhakti I have taught you.
Yeah.
Shashti Vibhakti is not a karaka, right? It is not a, you understand, right? What it's, why it is not a karaka? I explained that. Why it is not a
one of a, the way I understood it is it's a relationship between
yes
two things.
Or it's
the relationship.
Yeah. It gives, it represents the relation, the sambandha. Therefore, it is called sambandha shashti. It is not involved in the action directly. Example is Ramaha Gachati, we say, right? Rama goes. Where does Rama go? Rama goes to the forest. How do you translate?
Ramaha vanam gachati.
Now, the son of Dasharatha, Rama, goes to the forest. What is the connection between Dasharatha and the action going of Rama? Is there any connection? No connection. Dasharathi, when going is there, who goes? Ramaha goes. Ramaha gachati. Where does he go? Vanam gachati. Then how do you ask, how do you connect Dasharatha to going? It is not connected to going. it is not a factor involved in accomplishing the action of going, right? Yes.
Yeah.
No, therefore, Dasharatha is not connected to the action going. Therefore, it is not a Karaka. So, there is a Sambandha between Dasharatha and Rama. Right?
Yeah.
So, Dasharathasya Putraha Ramaha Vanangachati only you say. Even that, without Dasharathasya Putraha, it is, the sentence is fine. It makes sense. And it is not a the factor connected to the Kriya directly. It is connected to the Karta. So, therefore, Shashti Vibhakti, it represents the relation, the connectedness with any of the word in the sentence. Here, Ramaha, between Dasharatha and Rama, there is a relationship, connection. Dasharathasya Putraha Ramaha. Similarly, Vanam also can have some connection.
Like in this Kupaha.
Yeah.
Kupa has got some connection.
Connection. So, Vanam suppose is that, suppose it goes to Tataka Vanam. Right? Tataka, the forest of Tataka, where Tataka Rakshasi was there. Dasharathasya Putraha Ramaha Tatakayaha Vanam Gachati, we can say, right? The
yeah.
Vanam, forest of the Tataka. Tataka is the Rakshasi. What is the connection between the Tataka and the going Kriya of Rama? No connection. Tataka and Vanam has got relationship. Dasharatha and Rama has got relationship. So, Dasharathasya Putraha Ramaha Tatakayaha Vanam Gachati. So, Dasharatha and Tataka, it has no connection with the Kriya Gachati, right? Therefore,
yes.
Shashti Vibhakti is not a Karaka. So, here in this sentence, a fox comes near the well. So, Shighalaha Samipam Agachati. So, Kupasya Samipam, we can say. Or Kupa Samipam, make it simple. Kupa Samipam Agachati, one word. You can say Kupa Samipam or Kupasya Samipam, not Kupe.
Yeah.
Kupe is Saptami Vibhakti.
Saptami.
That will not come here. Kupasya Samipam Gachati. Right? It's clear, no?
Yes.
Sharanji, here the Karma Karaka is Samipa or?
Samipam. Samipam, it denotes the nearness, therefore Samipam.
And that becomes the Karma Karaka.
See, Shigalaha Kupam Agachati, we can say Karma. But Kupasya Samipam, it goes near the well. So,
yes.
It is not a Karma, it is something called Upapada. We will talk about it later.
Right.
See, so far we have seen only Karaka Vibhakti. That two Karaka Vibhakti only, Kartra Karaka, Karma Karaka, we have seen. We have not seen Karana Karaka, other Karakas we have not seen. And this is one part. And there is another type of Vibhakti that is called Upapada Vibhakti. What is that? Upapada Vibhakti.
Upapada.
So you cannot strictly classify, it's only if it's Karaka is there. Say, okay, I'll give another example. Rama goes to the forest with Sita. How do you translate? First it goes. Who goes?
Ramaha Vanam Gachati.
Ramaha Gachati. Kutra Gachati. Ramaha Vanam Gachati.
Vanam Gachati.
He goes along with Sita. How do you say?
Sitasya.
Along with.
Sita Yaha Saha.
Sita Yaga. What is Sita Yaga? What will
no, Sita. Yeah, Sita.
Why you use Saha? You have heard Saha somewhere, right?
Yes, along with. Saha no. Is along.
How do you know Saha is along? I mean, you have heard somewhere.
Yeah, right? Heard somewhere, yes.
So, okay. Sita Yaga Saha. It is not Sita Yaga. Sita Yaga is Shashti Bhakti. Saha is what? It's an Avyaya. So, because you are using the word Saha, that Sita will be in Tritiya Vibhakti. The Saha governs the word in Tritiya Vibhakti. Sitaya Saha. Rama, Ramaha, Sitaya Saha, Vanam Gachati. Not Sitaya. The Saha word governs the word, Saha governs the word Sita in Tritiya Vibhakti. So, that saha governs. Therefore, it is a upapada vibhakti. Sitaya is there. It is tritiya vibhakti. It is not a karana karaka, right? It is not the instrument, the means of accomplishing the action. We are not seeing karana, but still, in this example, since it is there, that therefore I have to talk about it. Karana. Karana is a means. See, kartakaraka is the doer of the action. Karma is the object on which the action is done. Then the karana is the means by which the action is accomplished. That will be in tritiya vibhakti. That is called karana karaka. Karana karaka will be in tritiya vibhakti. Here, Sita is not the karanam. Sita is not the means of accomplishing the action. Suppose if Rama goes to the forest by ratha, by chariot, how do you say Ramaha vanam gachati? How? Katam gachati? Ratena. Ratena you can say, right? Ratena is tritiya vibhakti. Understand?
Right.
So ratena gachati. Ratha is the means of accomplishing the action of going to the forest. So ratena tritiya vibhakti. But in this example, Ramaha sitaya saha vanam gachati. Sitaya is there. Sita is not the means. Sita is along with Rama, along with Sita. Therefore, it is a upapada. The saha word governs the Sita in tritiya vibhakti. Therefore, it's called upapada vibhakti. We have not seen. I'm just telling you. So, therefore, I gave this example to show you that we cannot strictly say this is karma. This is, if it is a karaka vibhakti, then we can say this is karta, this is karma, this is karana. If it is not a karaka, then it is upapada.
Upapada.
Understood?
Right.
Okay. Others, if you don't understand, don't worry. Our topic is not that. So we are not discussing it now. We will discuss that later. Our focus is only on this translation. If you understand this particular sentence, the fox comes near the well. Vihalaha kupasya samipam agachati is fine. Okay. Fine. The next one. The fox brings the lion and shows the well. Namaji.
Yeah. The fox brings the lion. Shrigalaha simham anayati. Simham anayati.
Shrigalaha anayati.
Anayati.
Okay. Kim anayati?
Simham anayati.
Simham anayati. Okay.
Then? Shows the well. Kupam darshayati.
Kupam darshayati. Darshayati.
Darshayati.
Cha.
Cha.
Shigalaha anayati darshayati. Singham anayati kupam darshayati cha. Okay. I think we can stop here. We discuss a lot of things, which are some certain things are which out of the scope of the current topic. Doesn't matter. If you understand, fine. But anyway, we are going to see Karana Karaka. I thought of introducing Karana today. Could not do it. Okay. So, if you have any doubts, you can ask. You can stop here. Any doubts?
Okay. Karaka. Karaka, what is literally translation in English? Karaka?
It is not? Okay. It's not Karaka. It is Karakam. Karakam is...
Karakam, what is the literary translation in English?
In English, factors of action. Factors of action. Factors involved in accomplishing an action is called karaka. What are the factors involved in accomplishing an action? Involved in an action. It's called karaka. Karta must be there. That is why you ask a question. Kaha gachati, Ramaha gachati. Ramaha kadati. What does he eat? Kim kadati? Ramaha rotikam kadati. So the karta karma, they are connected to the kadana kriya, eating action. Therefore they are karaka. Karta is called kartra karaka. Karma is called karma karaka. How does he eat? That will come karana. That we are going to see in the next class after this translation.
Thank you, sir.
Have you done the translation, all both Sanskritam also?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a simple translation. We'll see.
Can we say that prepositions, like words used in that scene?
Which preposition?
No, no, no. For the, he asked now, like, what is karakam? So you can say that prepositions, like we use in English.
No, we cannot say. We cannot say the preposition. Why? Because upapada also got preposition. Like the example, along with Sita. So with the by is there. In English, with and by is there. So you cannot literally take the English preposition as the karaka. That is the mistake generally people do. So in the translation, when they do, wherever from is there, for example, when from is there, they think it is we have to use panchami. Not like that. Not always panchami. For from is there, panchami should be used. From in the sense of the separation, the movement from a place, then only it is panchami, not all the time. So with is there, so with or by, not wherever with and by is there, so it doesn't mean that it's all tritiya, it's not like that. So don't go by the English preposition, that will give a the wrong translation. No, understand the karaka and understand the upapada vibhakti, upapada. First, understand karaka. When action is there, you ask this question, who does? How does they do? Who does? And what is the object on which the action is done? And how does they do? And who is the benefactor? Benefactor of the action? Or what is the purpose of action? Or who? What is the purpose of action? Or who is the recipient of the result of the action? Or from where the action is done, or where it is done in terms of time and place. These questions are answered by the karaka. Other than this, are answered by the upapada. Therefore, we cannot strictly say that the English prepositions are karaka and chalam there. It's difficult.
Okay.
That is why first we introduce karaka. First you understand karaka. You ask a question. Then ask a question and get the answer. Then whatever, wherever to maximum possible, you will be able to form the sentence. And if you cannot, where there is no, the difficulty is there, then you bring the upapada. When karaka, where karaka is not there, upapada comes.
Okay.
So that is why first we have to understand karaka very clearly. Karaka vibhakti, then upapada vibhakti. There only two things are there. One is karaka vibhakti, other one is upapada vibhakti. If it's not a karaka involved in the action, then it must be upapada. Simple.
Okay. Thank you.
Shamyatam Sharanji.
Yes.
In Boho, it is Sambodhana, no? Then can simply Bho or...
Boho, it's only Boho.
Boho only, okay.
It's an abhaya.
Okay.
Don't decline. Bhogo, bhuvaha. Stop like that. Bhogo is osa. Bhogo, magavadaya, or arye. You can use sambodhana.
Okay. Challenge. Thank you.
Thank you. We can stop here. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha. Dhanyavadaha.